What's up, everybody on YouTube? Welcome to Snodzilla Cards. This is my very first video. So thanks for stumbling across this and hope you enjoy. What this channel is essentially going to be is sports cards. Baseball, football is going to be the majority. What we'll be doing is ripping packs, boxes, things like that. What most of this is actually going to be is giveaways. My kids and myself have been watching several YouTubers out there that have kind of inspired us to do some things here. And one of the things is, you know, with the cards we open, we don't end up doing much with any of them except, you know, the major cards, and those are few and far between. So what we're going to do is be giving away a lot of these cards. But what I first want to do is kind of give you an intro as to everything else we'll be doing. You know, one of the things is I actually used to collect back in the 80s, you know, when they mass produced cards. You know, we live just outside of Cleveland here, so we're big Indians, Cavs, Browns fans, Ohio State Buckeyes. Myself, I personally collected through the years, Ken Griffey Jr., as you can see here, very iconic card as far as the hobby goes. You know, when Upper Deck first came out, this, you know, was the card to get. And I have a few of these and always looking to get more. Bo Jackson was another favorite of mine when I was a kid. As you can see, a card here. This is one of my personal favorite cards. I got this in a break, and for those again who are newer to the hobby, I'll go through explaining, you know, some of the newer things and what the hobby's like now compared to back then. But this is a Bo Jackson autograph, number 1 out of 25, one of my personal favorite cards. Barry Sanders is another one. There's a, you know, somebody who I personally collect. I have an 11-year-old son and a 9-year-old daughter who also enjoy cards. You know, they're both hometown favorites: Cavs, Indians, Browns, Buckeyes. But they have some of their favorites as well. But again, what we're ideally going to do here is open stuff and give away, and I'll go about later and explaining how I'll be giving these cards away and what I would like to do. In, you know, what I kind of like to go over here at first too is, you know, for those who might be newer to the hobby, I don't want to rattle on too long, but I'll give my first few videos as probably some tutorials as far as what retail cards are compared to hobby boxes, and, you know, just low end to high end, and how the hobbies really changed throughout the years. You know, what I got here today, what I'll actually be opening, is just retail packs that you could get from, you know, your local big box stores, Walmart, Target, you know, places like that, wherever you are in the United States, or where about whatever other stores you might have near you that sell these cards. I don't typically myself like to buy these packs from stores just because, you know, there's people out there who, you know, we call them the hobby pack searchers. And what they'll do is they'll go about and try to figure out, you know, if they could feel thicker cards in here. Because nowadays, if you look at, again, this Bo Jackson, this is a pretty thick card as compared to my Ken Griffey Jr. Now, you can't get this out of retail. This is going to come out of the hobby. And again, I'm going to have hobby boxes I end up opening on here. But again, I don't just typically go out and buy these. Just, you know, when they're on sale like this or something like that, they obviously can't go through and feel out what autograph cards might be in here. So you could still get those. But this is kind of maybe the area you want to start if you're, again, just getting back into the hobby. It's changed a lot through the years. Again, when I was a kid, it was about, you know, finding that favorite rookie player of yours. you know, it's still something you can do. And I do that. Guys just more recently, like Francisco Lindor is a big favorite of mine and my kids. But guys like Kris Bryant, Carlos Correa, you know, guys like that, you could go out and get their rookie cards. And it's amazing how quickly, you know, some of those could shoot up. I think I just saw somebody mention the other day, the Kris Bryant rookie, some people were, you know, selling, like actually selling on eBay for $50, which blows my mind. But, you know, you could still get cards like that. I've got speaking of a hot player, I've got a Dak Prescott I pulled out of a retail blaster box, which I'll show you in a little bit here what those are. But, again, if you're just new to the hobby, you know, this is a cheaper way to get started. And, you know, as you start growing and getting into, you know, if you start spending a little more money, you could go out and get hobby boxes. And I have some of those on order and some that I actually have at my house here. And I'll actually explain, you know, where I get them from. I'll provide them in, you know, links below where you could go about getting them. But, you know, when you start getting to hobby, things like that, it gets a little more expensive. So, this could be a very expensive hobby. You can make it however you want, you know, as cheap as you want or as expensive you want. And that's one of the reasons why we decided to do this channel. You know, we don't go out and spend a lot of money. I keep it pretty budgeted each month. But again, I don't, you know, some of these guys I don't collect. I do work card shows here and there with a buddy of mine. And, you know, we do it just for fun. I'm not looking, you know, make hundreds and hundreds of dollars, and you don't. It's more about, you know, meeting people and, you know, talking about the hobby and, you know, just sharing things with each other. So, yeah, hopefully we can have some fun with this. You know, and, you know, hopefully, you know, get, you know, this is a hobby that was essentially for kids. It's, you know, and it's fun for adults too. I'm not a young pup by any means, but, you know, it really be nice to see kids be able to get back into this hobby and enjoy it. And, you know, I'm not saying that they don't, but, you know, the price of some of this could get very expensive. So that's one of the reasons why, you know, myself and my kids decided to do this. They're not here with me at the moment, but essentially, when I talk about the giveaways that I want to do, I kind of want to have something where, you know, I might as well go and explain it now. But what I would like to do is have people, I'm going to provide an address, you know, send a letter in explaining, you know, who you are, you know, who you collect, how you got started, you know, what you like about the hobby, you know, if it's your father or mother or brother or sister or somebody, uncle that got you into the hobby. And what I'd, you know, if you've got a YouTube channel, because what I'd ideally like to do is when you send me in your letters on what you like and who you collect, and, you know, I want to base it on the cards that I open too. And you might put in there what cards you saw me open that you'd like. Or again, I just might have some of your personal collection here. But if you got a YouTube channel or something, make sure you put it in there so you get some recognition. Again, I don't know how many people are going to be watching this, but again, figure give it a shot and see what we could do with it. You know, there's a lot of good YouTubers out there that I've been watching that do some good things, which, you know, again, motivated my kids and myself to, you know, get a chance to give back to people and, you know, do some good things here. And again, a lot of these cards I will be giving away, you know, some bigger hits, you know, there's going to be some we want to keep for ourselves, but I, you know, a lot of it, you know, just your regular base cards or numbered cards, I've got no problem giving away, you know, some of those bigger hits, you know, if there's ones that people really, really want, you know, we'll figure out a way to come up with a contest or something. Maybe I just keep the letters and keep them grouped together as far as, again, who people collect and whatnot, and do some kind of raffle. We'll figure that out as we go along. But, yeah, so before I get started opening these rack packs, I was telling you about other ways you could get boxes at your local, again, Walmart, Target, places like that. These are called blaster boxes, and you can see they typically sell for $20. I have another one. Again, if you catch them at the right time, Sorry. You can get these on sale. I got this one for $12.99, which is typically $20. But it's a cheaper way to do it. You know, they give you, I forget how much these optic are really hot. Oh, here you go. So you get 4 cards per pack, 6 packs per box. They guarantee you rookies. Again, I pulled this Dak Prescott out of one of these boxes. You could get autographed, you could get jersey cards, things like that. So again, these are a good way to just kind of get started. Little cheaper. I don't have any hobby boxes with me at the moment, near me, I should say. But I will have videos on that. I'm going to open these blaster boxes at a later time. I also have, I don't want to really get into this yet, but these loot lockers. There's boom boxes. There's, I can't remember all the other ones. But they're basically, you subscribe to them. Here's a boom box. I haven't opened these yet either, but what you do is you subscribe to these, and you can do football, baseball, or basketball, and they'll send you packs monthly. But what's nice about it is they'll send you like some high-end packs. So, for example, one might be $30 a month. You might only get 5 packs, but then they have like bonus boxes. So you might get like a single, a double, a triple, and you know, you'll get extra packs. But some of these, and one I'm looking forward to opening is the football one, because they have the 2016 Select Football in there. Which is pulling some really nice cards. And again, look for those videos later. They also have these things out called hanger boxes. You could see a little advertisement there for Target, but you could get these at your local store. You know, they've got, usually like 40 cards or whatever in these, but again, you could get your autographs, relics, things like that. These typically only run $10. You can see I found one on sale for $7.98. So there is cheap ways to start off in the hobby. Typically that's a good way to start off there. Another big thing to have is your materials to protect your cards. Again, I don't know how many of you are newer or whatnot. Penny sleeves to keep them protected. But those are things you're going to want to do. I don't know if I showed you guys this yet. This is one I pulled out of a blaster box. You know, it's not a super high-end card or anything, but it's a jersey relic card there. And it is numbered 72 of 100. This will be a card I'll give away. So if you're a Carolina fan or Devin Funchess, again, you send me a letter in the mail. I will provide that again a little later, my address and everything. But let's get into some cards here. Let's take a look at, again, you guys who are veterans out there, you know what this is like for you newbies or young kids or, they're just newer to the hobby. Let's save that one for a second here. You know what? I will go with that one. It's just this sticker. I don't want to bend the cards. This is being a little pain right now. But this will give you a good look at kind of, you know, hopefully we'll get something good, as we call a hit in the hobby. Those are your autographs and things like that, numbered cards. I'm not a big numbered card guy. I was just talking to my wife about that tonight. Unless it's, you know, again, like an autograph or relic, you know, that has some kind of jersey or something in it. It's just the whole number thing doesn't do much for me. I mean, that's got a nice little dent in that card, but this is a Bowman Chrome. These are really nice cards. These are really nice cards to get graded to. They graded well. They grade well, I should say. When you get into the whole grading card thing, again, people who are new to this, it protects your card, and, you know, the higher the grade, you know, the card is worth more, you know, things like that. But let's go through this here. We got a Nate Smith from Anaheim. Nick Treviso from the Reds. Trey Mancini. This is a Bowman First from Baltimore. Fernando Perez. Jorge Alfaro. Tyrell Jenkins. Richie Martin. Billy McKinney. Jake Bowers. Nick Plummer. So nothing big there. But again, if you see something you like, Again, send me a letter. Let me know. We'll get to the, again, the address a little later. None of those guys I personally collect. Let's get to the other pack here. Again, these Bowman, they're nice cards. Adrian Beltre, solid player. Sonny Gray, another good player. Paul Goldschmidt, heck of a ball player. Yankee Rob Refschneider, rookie card. Steven Strasburg, getting some bigger name players here. Yu Darvish, there we go. Carlos Correa, sophomore standout. And if you're a Correa fan, let me know. International Inc., Jason Guzman. Nothing big there. Chris Archer, nice solid pitcher. Brian Dozier. And a Kyle Schwarber, rookie card. So, again, any Schwarber fans, Cubs fans, I'm sure there's plenty out there. They beat my Indians this past year. It's a heck of a World Series. Let's get on to the next Bowman pack. So what I was stating early as far as giving away, I'm going to give away majority of these cards. So what we're going to do is what I would like people to do again is, you know, send me a letter, tell me again, you know, who you like to collect, who your favorite players are, teams, you know, if you're a kid, how old you are, how long you've been doing it for. And what I would like you to do, you know, I don't mind giving away the cards, but one thing I do ask when you send a letter, if you could send a self-addressed envelope with the postage on it, just something similar to this. Again, this is Snodzilla Cards, the nickname I had a little younger. But this is the address you'd send it to, P.O. Box 694. That's Chesterland, Ohio, 44026. Put a little stamp up there for me and with your letter. And again, I'll do videos of the mail day. You know, if I'm fortunate enough for people to send me letters, my kids really get a kick out of stuff like that. And I will probably have them on here with me, you know, reading some of these. I know my daughter is looking forward to it. She, she actually will take cards to school and trade with, you know, boys and kids in her class. What's kind of sad is the teachers have kind of banned that. I don't know if it's causing a distraction or what. I mean, I guess they could see it some, but, you know, the kids are doing a harmless thing. You know, they're having fun. So my daughter's looking forward to seeing some of these, and maybe I'll have her read some of these off, and, you know, she'll help put together, my son will help put together the cards out. I'm not going to send the higher end hits in these self-addressed envelopes you send to me. I'll actually send them in, you know, again, if you get picked out to get some of the nicer cards, I will send them in, you know, protected envelope and things like that. But here, let's get back to this. We got a Chris Sale, a Jacob DeGrom, both great pitchers. Buster Posey, you know, great ball player. Garrett Richards, Troy Tulowitzki, it's one of my buddy's favorites. Jason Hayward, Francisco Lindor, that's going in my personal collection. Ooh, look at that. Rob Kaminsky, another Indian. Bowman Scouts Top 100. That will go into my own personal collection. Sorry for any of you Indians fans out there, but got this in the other one. It's got a green border, though, and this one is numbered. So this one's numbered, I don't know if you could see that right up here, 51/99. So again, if you are a KC fan, Jason Guzman, put that off there. Miguel Amonte, Miguel Cabrera, and Ryan Howard. So yeah, again, when you send in these letters, I'm, you know, really interested to hear what, you know, everybody kind of does out there. Again, I'll be doing football, baseball. At some point, I'm sure I'll be doing some basketball again because my son's really, you know, into basketball. Let's see, we got a Garrett Whitley here, Richie Martin, and these are the chrome ones. So you got your regular, just kind of cardboard. You can see the difference, the glossy and just the regular. Kyle Holder, Lucas Giolito, Victor Robles, Kyle Tucker, Dansby Swanson, good ball player there, Colby Allard, Jeff Hoffman. I want to say he came to the Indians now. I know one of those guys did. And Trent Clark. So again, any of those you like, let me know. The other thing I ask in order to qualify to get these cards, other than just sending me your letter explaining, you know, again, your background, how you got into cards and things like that, and the self-addressed envelope, is I ask that you like and subscribe to our page. Just kind of that way I know you're watching, and just kind of, my kids are excited to see how it goes here. So what we're opening now is a 2017 Top Series 1. I saved these personally for last just because there's some good ones you could get out of there. Here's a Starling Marte, Adam Eaton, Freddie Galvis, Christian Frederick, Drew Smiley, Jose Fernandez. Man, what a shame. He was a heck of a ball player. I actually got I was fortunate enough to get a nice autograph card of his, and that's one I'll be keeping for myself. But sad story. Cesar Hernandez, Xander Bogaerts. He's on my fantasy team. I'd like to see a big year out of him. Yoquan Benoit, Tyler Chatwood. Sorry, getting a little higher there. Brian Goodwin, rookie. And Kyle Barraclough. I'm not going to try to butcher that. So again, any of those you see in there, let me know. And now we're going to get into a Topps Series 2. Now let's hope for some good stuff out of these. I've had some luck with these in the past. That's kind of why I save these for last. All right, we got a Matt Clark rookie, Jared Parker, Joe Panic. There we go, Cleveland Indians. Again, that goes into the personal collection. John Holdscom, it's a rookie. I'm not even going to try to say that. Young Gervis Solarte. Spin that around. Ryan Flaherty. Look at that. Kris Bryant rookie. I was just talking about these. I don't know. I have to check. I know if some of you that might have been in the hobby back in the day and just getting back into it, you remember Beckett's and Tough Stuff to use as a guide to see what values of cards are. The Beckett's still are out there. It's a good kind of guide to go by, but cards never typically sell for that. Your best bet is to go onto eBay and look for sold listings, and that'll give you a good idea of what these cards sell for. And most likely, I probably will give this away. I have a couple Kris Bryants in my collection, maybe you like to see this go to a kid or somebody who, is really getting into the hobby. So I'm going to put that one aside. We got a gold Kris Coghlan, who is a Cub. This should be numbered, which it is, 582 out of 215. Let's put that over there. Stepping up insert, Dodgers, Duke Snyder. So again, if you're a Dodgers fan, let me know. Willie Mays, any Giants fans out there? Rod Carew, Mike Trout. Nice little cool inserts. These aren't any high-end cards, but very cool. Nice Cal Ripken insert there. Got a Mark Burley for Toronto. Mike Avilas, who's no longer on the Indians. Heck of a guy, though, and that'll still go into my personal collection, even though he's not on the Indians. Will Middlebrooks. Alfredo Simon. And Nelson Cruz. So definitely happy with that first part there, getting a Kris Bryant rookie. Not bad for a $4 pack. That's why I snagged these up when I saw them. Couldn't pass on that. Here's a little, in case somebody tried stealing it. All right, let's see what we got. Brett Cecil, CeCe Sabathia, ex-Indian, Chris Medlin, Nick Markakis, Hunter Strickland, rookie, Melvin Mercedes, rookie, Caleb Joseph, Craig Kimbrell, Patrick Corbin, Jose Quintana. We got a Nelson Cruz insert. Giovanni Gallardo, AJ Griffin, Christian Bettencourt's future stars. Sorry, I'm getting a little off-center there. Nick Swisher. Short-lived time in these. He did have a good season that first year and got him into the playoffs, that run he had. AJ Burnett, Justin Morneau, Cameron Maben. So again, not a bad pack there. I got a, any time you could get a Kris Bryant rookie for $348, definitely not going to complain. So this is going to be the last pack here. You know, maybe we could pull another Kris Bryant. We'll see here. Be nice to get some kind of auto or something out of one of these. But you see how hard it is. It's not always easy. I see people have a lot of luck, though. Irvin Santana, Asdrubal Cabrera, who's an ex-Indian. Travis Snyder, the St. Louis Cardinals. Xavier Scruggs, rookie. Homer Bailey. Kris Iannetta, sorry about that. Kris Coghlan again, but that last one was a gold border. Speaking of gold border, Homer Bailey insert. Again, this is numbered. Oops, 181 on a 215. Jim Palmer insert. Matt Adams insert. Heart of the order. Craig Biggio, till it's over insert. He was a heck of a ball player. Yeah, it's that same Cal Ripken. You got two of those. Got your just little bunt advertisement. Benoit, we got one of those before. Brandon Barnes. Justin Regano. Galvin Floyd, Indians. That goes into the collection. And Will Venable. All right, so down to our last part here. Again, you know, if you're still on this and still watching, thanks for joining us. Again, at the end, I'll give out that address again and hopefully to hear from some of you. Francisco Liriano, Eduardo Nunez, Brennan Bosch, Bronson Arroyo, Ave Guerra, Jew Kelly, Josh Beckett, Clayton Kershaw, Darren O'Day, Rodis Vizcaino, a Hunter Pence first home run insert, a TJ House Indian. Can't complain about the Indians I got. Joe Panic future star, Melky Cabrera, Chase Headley, Matt Shoemaker future star, Skip Shoemaker, Cody Ash, and just that. Cards. So, no inserts, no autographs, anything like that. But again, I can't complain. I got that Kris Bryant, which we're going to go ahead and protect. Again, we'll put that in a little penny sleeve here. And get that top loaded, that way this protects it. For anybody who may be getting this or who I may be sending this out to. There we go. You know, maybe I should have done my little mojo before. Give me my Joe Boo mojo to help us out with some of the cards and getting hits. I got my little Harry Doyle from Major League the Movie. Oops. Oh. Sorry about that. But again, you know, again, if you happen to stumble upon this, thanks for hanging in there, watching this first video. I'm sure it probably wasn't the smoothest, but, you know, hope to see, you know, some people send us some things and so I could give away these cards. Again, if you send me a letter in the mail with a self-addressed envelope to Snodzilla, P.O. Box 694, Cheshireland, Ohio, 44026, with, again, who you collect, you know, your name, how you got started, if you got a YouTube, Twitter, any of those social media things, I'll be happy to, you know, we're all one big community here, kind of helping each other out. But, you know, again, I appreciate if you like, subscribe, put any comments, you know, tell me what you think. Hopefully these videos won't be going as long in the future, but they're going to be coming out quite often. Again, I'm going to read, you know, if I do happen to get anything in the mail, I will read those live on here on any mail days. If I get any breaks or anything like that, I'll open those live, you know, not live, but, and again, for those that are newer, I'll be kind of explaining a lot of these things as I go through them. But, again, start looking. I'll have videos out on opening the hanger boxes, blaster boxes, any of those special subscription loot lockers, boom box. I can't think of the other one. I subscribed to three of them, and I'm going to have some hobby box and more packs to open. I placed a decent size order. But again, thanks for checking out Snodzilla Cards. You know, enjoy yourself and keep ripping those cards and hitting all those inserts. Have a good day.